90% of traders use the VWAP the wrong way and lose money. In this video, I'm going to share with you my high win rate VWAP trading strategy and reveal to you how to use it the right way, including a TradingView script for backtesting and live trading. Let's get right into how this VWAP trading strategy works. We're using the VWAP, the 30 EMA and the 200 EMA to get entry and exit signals. We apply them to the 4-hour or the daily chart. Let's look at the trading setup. This strategy is designed to find pullbacks and trending markets on a higher time frame and use them as entries into the direction of the trend to catch larger swings. An entry consists of three simple steps. As a first condition, the 30 EMA needs to be above the 200 EMA. Price needs to be above the 30 EMA, and the 30 and 200 EMA need to be spread out, pointing upwards. This means we are in an uptrend. If the 30 and 200 EMA are not spread out and moving in parallel, we will not be taking any trades, as this means we are in a ranging market. The second condition is that we need to have a dip or a close below the VWAP. If afterwards we get a close above the VWAP, we enter a long trade. Ideally, we want this to happen within just a few candles. Remember, we are trading this strategy on a high time frame, so the price action has much more relevance. To set our take profit, we use the average true range with the discretionary multiplier. In the TradingView script, you can adjust this. I recommend you backtest this so you can find the best multiplier for the assets you are trading. We will get right into how to do this in just a minute. For our stop loss, we are going to be using a trailing stop loss. You can also configure and backtest this with the TradingView script, which I will show you in just a bit. We will either exit on take profit or stop loss, or when the market bias flips, meaning the 30 EMA crosses below the 200 EMA. For the short setup, the conditions are the exact opposite. So let's get right into how to adjust and backtest this VWAP strategy for different assets using the TradingView script I created for you. We will be looking at a few different examples and backtest results for stocks, futures and cryptocurrencies. Before we do that, if you enjoyed this video so far, please take the time to like it and subscribe to the channel now. There are two main parameters for this trading strategy that are very important in order to optimize it for different assets: the ATR multiplier and what I call the range filter. Let's look at the ATR multiplier first. It is responsible for setting appropriate take profit targets based on the average true range of the asset we are trading. As the name implies, the average true range tells us by how much the asset is moving up and down over a given period of time. We use this range and multiply it by a discretionary factor to control our take profit target. You can configure both the ATR lookback period and the multiplier right here. We will look at how to use this exactly in just a bit when we go over the backtests for some example assets. So let's go over the next key parameter, the range filter. As I mentioned before, the key to this strategy is that we only want to trade in trending markets, meaning that the two exponential moving averages are spread out, pointing either upwards or downwards. If they are moving in parallel or close to each other, it means we are in a range. We do not want to trade this strategy when we are in a range, so the TradingView script is designed to filter out ranges. It does this by looking at the spread of the two exponential moving averages. The spread is simply the difference between the larger and the smaller moving average. For every asset, the spread of the moving average that constitutes a range will be different, and it will also change over time. So we use the average true range again, together with a discretionary multiplier that can be adjusted right here. You can see that as we play around with the range filter, this changes the profitability and win rate considerably. You can also see on the chart that this is due to the ranges being filtered properly or not. If the range filter is not set appropriately, the strategy will make trades during ranging markets, which leads to lower profitability. So now, let's look at some backtest results of this VWAP strategy for three different types of assets: stocks, commodities and cryptocurrencies that I've been successfully trading with it myself. For the stocks example, let's look at Apple. As you can see, the backtest has been run over 21 years from 2000 until 2021 on the daily time frame, and it actually covers several periods where the market crashed, like in 2000 and 2008. Yet, we can achieve a win rate of 82% and a profit factor of 3.7 with the configuration shown on the screen. Let's look at an example for commodities using crude oil on the 4-hour time frame. Backtested over 6 years, we can achieve a win rate of about 77% with a profit factor of 2.3. Looking at the chart, we can see that we are only trading the trends and are staying out of the market during ranges. And finally, a backtest for everybody's favorite cryptocurrency, Bitcoin. As you can see, the strategy achieves a win rate of 94% with a profit factor of 21. Keep in mind that these huge results are also due to the fact that Bitcoin, since its inception, has gone through strong trends in which this strategy performs best. Now that we have looked at the backtest results, let's go over the configuration. The main parameters you need to set when backtesting or live trading are the time frame, the range filter, the ATR multiplier, and the time period. You can change all the other configurable parameters as well, but these are the main ones that I'm working with. The most important one is definitely the range filter, as it has the biggest impact on win rate and profit factor by filtering out ranges that otherwise would generate a lot of unprofitable trade signals. As you will see when trying out different parameters, the win rate of a strategy is definitely not the most important aspect. You will be able to be profitable even with a win rate below 50% when you have appropriate money management, meaning position size, stop loss, and take profit. A win rate of 60% compared to a win rate of 80% might, for example, also be able to generate higher profits in absolute terms, so try out different combinations. If you try out this strategy, let me know what parameters you use for what assets in the comments down below. So, this strategy works best trading stocks, commodities, and crypto. You can use it for trading Forex as well, however, as the VWAP is based on volume and there's no real volume data available in Forex, I would not recommend it. If you're looking for a similarly high win rate strategy for Forex, check out the video linked here. Now, if you're still watching, you're obviously interested, so I would like to take a minute to explain to you why this strategy actually works. Any asset or market will basically always be in either of two states, a trend or a range. Once we are able to identify a trend while filtering out ranges, which is easy to do by using the 30 and 200 EMA, it all comes down to finding a high probability entry. As I mentioned before, this is done by using the VWAP. The VWAP shows us at what price level the liquidity is largest. This is important because the smart money uses the VWAP to execute large orders around it where they can find the most liquidity in order not to move the market to their disadvantage. A pullback beyond the VWAP in an existing trend is a healthy aspect of a trending market. So if we get another close above or below the VWAP afterwards, this gives us a high probability trade setup for an entry as more volume is being traded into the trend direction, which indicates that the trend will continue. By using dynamic parameters based on the ATR for our take profit, as well as the range filter, we can catch large swings in trending markets across different assets while maximizing our profits. If you enjoyed this video, I would highly appreciate it if you leave a like and subscribe so that we can continue providing high quality trading education for you for free. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.